Yeah, we're back at this one. I guess we're calling it the Splatocaster. That other Pacific and Aqua shit, I'm going to sacrifice it to the gods of extreme heat. But here's a reason you have to visit Solo Guitars. Okay. In the store, because you have to go to the store, are a whole big pile of necks that they couldn't sell because they have little things wrong with them. So this one has that little, I don't know what it is, a Ginja stain, something. Who cares? That's what it's getting. So, I think we're okay. I gotta find some tuners for this. Maybe I'll grab the ones out of the neck that I'm gonna burn by heat. Whatever. Find some tuners. Or, it's easier to play with the neck and drill those holes without the weight of the tuners. Let's do that first. Little transfer punch action. Oh, this one might be tough to get. Please, baby, please. Remarkably enough, the new holes are nowhere near where the pre-drilled holes were, but like I said, this is a reject from a kit. $5. $5. I paid for that neck. That's why you gotta go to the store. Just to continue about that, the reason there's all that stuff there is because when the kits are brought in before they leave the store, they get a full quality control check. And if there's any little, like I said, this isn't the end of it. I don't know. It looks like they tried to fix it with some wood filler, and it doesn't matter. The next straight truss rod works. It's rock and roll all night and party every day on the Splatocaster. Let's drill some holes and pin the neck onto that thing, and then I will find tuners carry on. I don't know, this could be a new TV show. You send me your junk parts and I will attempt to cobble them together into a guitar. What do you think? Get yourself in there. I'll be back. I need three hands and a monkey here. Sorry for the BG noise. Furnace is still running. Jeebus. This is as far as I'm going to go. I don't know. I think this is the guitar for the studio, right? For the guitar player that screws around too much, there's your knob. That's all you get. Play guitar and you can turn up and down. Only if we say so. That's pretty much going to be it. The neck angle's good. Left to right placement, I got to put a couple strings on it. Front to back placement, that's pretty much not super critical because we have bridge saddles we can move around. When measuring the scale length, always go for the tiniest string. Right, so 25 and a half, you want that to be there. $5 neck, orphan thing, I don't know, should we add a tone control? Nah, I don't think so. Actually, no, I'm going to add one that does nothing. Even a better idea. Actually, I'll add two other knobs that do nothing. Just to give you the, you know, make the guy feel good, I guess. Okay, what's next? In order to place this, I'm going to have to put a couple of strings on it, which means I got to put the claw in and put trem springs on it. Buzzer, I don't have any. So I'm going to stop. We'll get there. It's timed and saw the claw. The claw. I see a lot of this. Just go with me here. Okay. You see that screw that has that nice smooth shoulder? That's the correct screw for the claw. Right. This is not the correct screw for the claw. And I'll explain why. Because what happens, okay, is, you know, if you've watched the setup, you're going to turn this tight, loosen it, turn this tight. And what happens is it peels all the worm off the side of the screw. And then that's why they pull out of the wood, because they've been ground down by, you know, I mean, it doesn't take a lot. So that's why these are the right screws. Next thing that drives me nuts is getting the right angle so that the screwdriver, you can get it, right? So the answer, I'll get a bit closer. The answer to this problem is right in my hand. So what you do is you take the claw, right? Take the claw and spin it upside down in the opposite direction it goes, and put that back in the cavity. And that, if you use that as your guide when you drill the pilot holes, I'll just get a close up of that. Hold on. Watch the whip cam. Okay, whip pan. Okay, so like I said, if you just take the claw, which wants to live there, and you want the screws to be, the angle is built into it. Right. Flip that over, and I'm just demonstrating with a screw, but you protect that with tape or whatever. I'm just going to start the pilot hole at that angle. And then when I install the claw, I'll be able to get to the screws with the screwdriver. Humpty Dumpty fell off the wall. So once again, I'm just using the backside of the claw to try and get the right angle. I might have drifted a bit, but we'll be okay. A little bit of wax in the threads. And these should be angled enough that the screwdriver will hit them. We have a claw. I'm going to put that dot of solder on it now. Be done with it. Done. It always helps to scrape a bit of plating off of there before you blob that on. Well, a couple of shit strings to align this. Left to right, front to back. I'll show you the back. There's a little spacer in there to keep this where it needs to be. And what I'll do is, I can't pilot freaking reflections in camera. I can't pilot those holes while the strings are on it, because that's holding it exactly where it needs to be. So I'll do the four, and then I'll sink the screws, loosen those off. Let me show you the back. This thing is pretty much ready to come together. I gotta finish the electronics, which isn't much, and I think I have a better pickup to put in there than what's in there. Also, smashed out the plastic nut. I have a new nut with better string spacing, but this is a shredder guitar. It's a 20 radius. This is like flat, man. That's, you'd be able to do like bends in all directions. Time to fix the electronics. Got to drill a couple more holes. the claw up, and I put a trem stopper in as well, just because I had them. Thanks, Dave Parker, for that. Let's get this making noise, and I think we're pretty close to strings. Oh, string tree. Okay, I'm going to drill as many holes as I can, but I'm still going to have to drill a couple holes at the end, namely the string tree, and I don't care about the strap buttons right now. I'm drilling a hole where the screw goes in. Really not much to do but throw strings on it and see if it blows up. Well, that's the end of another orphan. Rips pretty good. It does. The $5 neck. Every fret works. Shout out to Black Cloud, who sent me the body. Stretching. Just give a shot of the back. Well, look, I got all the bits. Strap buttons, knob, wing. Sounds like my stomach. Anyhow, I don't know what we do. Parts. The only thing I was like strings. $5 neck out of the scrap pile at Solo, but you gotta go to the store to get those. A couple of string trees, leftover tuners, all leftover parts. All derelict orphaned stuff that now has become a thing. It has become a guitar-shaped object. Still a couple to go that other green monster thing is in the body shop getting refabricobbled. All the great links to stuff are below. Just as I keep you hanging here, please watch the end. If you sent me money for a sticker, please include your address. Because what happens is I get no address, and then PayPal fucked over the whole interface and decided that I can only send you a message to tell you that I need your address. They don't include your email anymore. So I don't know how you get those messages. I don't know when PayPal tells you. I don't know. Anyway, please just include your address. It's like two sentences. You can become a patron. You can Twitter me. You can Facebook group. Join, you can subscribe, you can, oh shit, just try to be good to each other. You don't have to like each other, just try to be good to each other. Even if you have to, I don't know. Cheers, folks.